started wrestling when I was 12. I played football, baseball, basketball my whole life. I was really into football because it was the hardest sport. So, you know, it seemed like the most fun thing for me. I always wanted to do the hardest thing I could. And my first day of wrestling practice, I knew that I was doing something harder than football. And so I really fell in love with it. And, you know, I became a state champion in high school. And I remember, I think I was a senior in high school, and I was watching TV with my dad, and the UFC came on, and it was playing highlights, and there's some guys fighting, I don't know who they were, and I remember looking at my dad and being like, that's crazy, these guys are lunatics, I'd never do that. And then, you know, but I was thinking too, while I was watching, I'm like, you know, I think I know what to do there because of wrestling. And I got to college, and my college roommate's from Huntington Beach, and so he always talked about Tito Ortiz. Started watching video at Tito, and it kind of got me into it. It made me excited, you know, kind of, I've been wrestling for so long, it wasn't boring, but it just kind of got to the point where it was the same thing every day. So it gave me something else to look forward to when I got done wrestling in college. And I found, before my senior year of college, right before I started that year, I found a jiu-jitsu gym in Birmingham while I was home for a little while, and started training jiu-jitsu there, got to where I liked it, and then went back and wrestled my last year of college. Won an NAIA national championship, and you know, after that, I went full speed into MMA, a lot of jiu-jitsu, a lot of Muay Thai. You know, and I was real excited about it, a lot of fun. You know, at first, you know, it's just exciting, it's something new. I've been doing wrestling for so long, it was nothing new. Now I had something new to do, so it was exciting. And now it's just become one of those things that I do. It's my job. I don't think of it as any different than anybody else going to a job, you know. And anything I want to do, I want to be the best at. So I know I got to be there every day, and I got to outwork everybody else. So that's my goal every day, is to work out, outwork everybody else in my weight class. I guess my motivation comes from I want to be the best at what I do, you know, and this is what I do right now, and it's what I plan on doing for a while. So I'm not going to do something and not go as hard as I possibly can. So. You know, I see somebody in the UFC fight, and I think, okay, that guy did this, so I've got to be better than that. I got to know how to beat that. So, get in the gym, you know, every single day, twice a day, and work as hard as I can. There's a lot of days when I get in, I'm like, I don't feel like sparring today, or I don't want to do this today. And then I think about it, you know, what's going to make me better? What's going to make me be the best that I can possibly be at this sport? And the only way to be the best in the world is outwork everybody else in the world. So, that's what I'm trying to do every single day.
Guys. Been around for a long time. He's done a great job, you know, teaching and filling in for teaching, deserves it, this promotion big time. I think it's well overdue for this guy, and he's shown a lot of dedication to the jiu-jitsu program here in Fresno, and today's promotion. I'd like to just bring a special guest to give the promotion on behalf of Dethrone Base Camp in Fresno. And you know, so as you guys all know, and kept the secret for quite a while here, you know, John Salter's coach.
Guys, I'm here to do one thing. I have to give John Salter his black belt. Big hand for John. John's been my toughest training partner that I've ever had. I've trained with a lot of people, but he's the one that beat me like I needed to be beat. Helped me win the Pan Ams in 2012. Helped me a lot in 2011. So I'm proud to give John his black belt. Yeah!
Started doing jiu-jitsu because I did MMA, and I just decided, well, I don't want to be that wrestler that takes people down and gets submitted, so I need to get good on the ground. And the more I did it, I have a friend that kept trying to get me to do gi, and I kept telling him not putting pajamas on to grapple. And one day he got me to do it, and I hated it. I did it another day, and I thought, that isn't too bad. I just kept doing jiu-jitsu in the gi, you know. I didn't really care for a belt. I just went and trained every morning with my friend that, you know, really one of my friends was doing gi at the time. So every morning we trained together, and I kept saying, I don't care about a belt. He was a purple belt, and I would submit him some, and he would always talk about how to go get a belt. I just always said, I don't care about getting a blue belt or anything like that. So I did jiu-jitsu for a while in a gi without ever taking a belt, and then I went straight to purple belt. And then that kind of really lit a fire under me and wanting to get better and be good in the gi and you know, get belted and learn everything I could about the gi. And it kind of made jiu-jitsu become part of my life, more than just being part of MMA. It was something where I never missed a jiu-jitsu practice. I try not to miss any practices, but jiu-jitsu is one that I've got to be there every day, you know. And after I moved to Nashville and went under Sean Hammonds, that was when I really started taking off with my jiu-jitsu. Before, I had good people to work with and some good coaches, but I never had anybody like Sean that could really show me everything that I was going to need to know, and that was a really high-level black belt. And got a lot better there, and that really went a long way for me. Got my brown belt while I was in Nashville. And then I moved out to California a little over a year ago. I've been training hard, you know, in gi and no gi every day. And then I had my coach Sean come out about a month and a half ago and promote me to black belt. And yeah, that's an exciting thing because my jiu-jitsu coach is a good friend of mine. So it's exciting to have him promote me and to be a black belt now. It means a lot to me. I feel like, you know, it's a lot of work I put in, a lot of hours I put in on the mat, so it means a lot to have it, and it's not the end of the journey, it's just part of it. You know, I'm fighting Jamie Hara Friday. He's a real tough guy. You know, I've watched some of his fights. He's just a guy that won't go away. He's got a lot of heart. Real tough. Good stand-up. Good jiu-jitsu. I mean, he's a pretty well-rounded guy. There's really not a weak point to talk about him. I'd like to say, oh, you know, he's not good at this. He's not good at that. But he's a tough guy all around. So, you know, this is a big fight for me. I had a fight in the XFC where I hurt my neck and I was out for a while. I came back with one quick win. I need to stack another win on that, you know, coming off of that loss and that long injury. So it's a big fight for me. I'm excited about it. I put everything I have into it, and just got to go out there and perform.
John Souther, I'm in Jara. Hara. Jamie. Hara.
Fun. 185.
thing right here.
With a record of 9 wins and 3 defeats from Dethrone Base Camp at Fresno, California, John Soldier!
Ladies and gentlemen, we have your winner. 2 minutes and 20 seconds into the first round. Tap out due to the triangle choke, John Soldier! Don't forget to visit Center Club. You get free $10 for new members, $5 for recommending a member, only one time a day. Once again, don't forget to visit the Center Club. Free $10 for new members, $5 for new members.
Hey! Sharp.